Hello and welcome back to My Mic Is Now Working. I had thought it was working, it apparently was not. My apologies. This is continuing my tutorial campaign in Realistic Progression Zero, the campaign mod for the Realism Overhaul Suite of Realism Mods in Kerbal Space Program. It's a continuation of part 55, where we're launching a bunch of probes towards Mars. We've just gone ahead and gone to the pad on, I believe this is OWL 5. We'd like to launch that Sparrow that I've just started rolling out, but it's not done rolling out yet, so we'll launch this right now. Now, technically, we probably shouldn't be able to roll out something else to Pad 1, which hasn't finished reconditioning yet, but Kerbal Construction Time still lets you do that, so I'm just going to go ahead and do that. We realized we didn't We under pitched on our ascent, so I've raised that. I've raised the turn end altitude. So let's go ahead and target the moon, as is our wont. So this target, launch into the plane of the target. That's in 22 hours and 18 minutes. Okay, I guess we'll go ahead and warp to it. Watching the clouds go by overhead. Rolls into the nighttime till the daybreak rolls around. We will be launching into daybreak, although we will obviously be launching at night, but into dawn. Okay, we are just about to come out of warp. Yep, so we're at T-minus 5, four, oh no, sorry, now we're at 5, 4, 3, ignition, 2, 1, and liftoff. Someday those plumes will get fixed. Ah. Come on. Let me disable you. There we are. And there's the lights of the runway. Let's zoom out and see the lights all around us. Look at the brightness of the space coast. Now we can see our launch vehicle silhouetted against the lights of the cities to our south as we slowly arc off into the east and out into the mid-Atlantic. Well past Mach 1, approaching Max Q. Hit Max Q, under 30 kilopascals. Minute 30 burn time remaining on this lower stage. It has our usual two NK-33 engines. and I'm going to stand ready to send us back a little bit north of our current heading of 95 degrees true. Okay, dropping past 9 kilopascals of dynamic pressure. So 7,000 pascals. Time to head back east, or a bit north of east. 3,500 pascals. Pressure is dropping off as we pass 40 kilometers in altitude. We've pitched over rather severely now. Expanding plumes as we go under a single kilopascal. We're down to 900 pascals. You can also see the little tiny bit of rosy finger dawn, as the poet would say. 15 seconds to first stage burnout. Pitch up. Fairing separation as we pass the Karman line. Now, let's check our RCS staging this time. These need to come up to here. These are the main RCS events. Alright, that all works out better. Okay, we're already up almost to 185 kilometers apogee. Still 5 minutes remaining on the stage. Less than 2 minutes to apogee, however, although that obviously will be stretched out because we're pitched above horizontal. Still gaining more apogee. Okay, and you can just make out the stage now. We're high enough that we're getting just a few rays from the sun. Up before we fall down. And we can see our these things. This time I'm going to go ahead and activate this while I remember to early on, just in case. Once again, it is going to be a long coast period, which is quite annoying. But as we demonstrated on the last launch, we're not going to lack for hydrogen, or delta V indeed, period, from this balloon tank stage. Power of hydrolux. And we'll quickly pass apogee and start falling back down. Remember, as usual, my goal is about 185 km insertion, zero vertical loss. Start a long fall back down to 185 km. Okay, well now we're down to 20 minutes and 30 seconds. Back up to the 15 degrees we had before. Even more, because we were at 260 meters per second sink rate. That's quite a lot of sinkage. So we'll go back to our severe pitch up. Now we're at 5 seconds a kilometer, give or take. 10 kilometers between, now only 8 kilometers between here and our target. Approaching second stage burnout. And there we are. Now that sink rate is increasing, so we've got to pitch up again quite severely. Below our target altitude. We're still pitched up quite severely. Yeah, I'm just not nailing these launches. Guess we should have launched to a higher apogee then. RCS is still firing. We don't need it to be firing. And let's target the moon again because we lost it from before. Alright. Pitch down some more. And we're going to end up about the same orbit as last time. That's pretty funny. About a little over 700 meters per second to orbit. 710 or so, maybe. 720, depending on our steering losses. Alright, let's pitch down a good bit more. Ready to kill our ascent. There we are, within 2 kilometers of a circular orbit. That's not bad. Now, let's set up our Mars transfer. Yon pork chop plot. Okay, and $36.95. Create. All right, that is again in 50 minutes. So let us, let us orient towards the sun. Quite precisely. That looks about right. All right, so I thought I was switched to locked. Apparently I was not. Alright, we've gone well past the sun now. Okay, that's good. And we'll inch our way over. That's about right. Okay. Now we are sun aligned. We about here, and then we'll align with the maneuver node, and I'll go ahead and once again dump propellants and prepare for the actual maneuver. I'm going to remove that and rebuild the node. Create node. All right, that's in 7 minutes. Let's orient towards the node. Four minutes, 27 seconds. All right, so we want now to start dumping liquid oxygen. That's acceptable. Liquid hydrogen. We also want to dump some liquid hydrogen. What just happened? Whoa, what is this even doing? Robin 5. I must have somehow clicked on... Alright, where's... There's Owl 5. Switch 2. Alright. We are still rotating. We have way too much liquid hydrogen for what we need, so we're going to start dumping it. Alright. That is acceptable. And line up on the node. Now, that's 3 minutes and 40 seconds, which means we would expect 180 plus 4, 220, 110, so 1 minute and 50 seconds for, whoops. All right. So at about 2 minutes, we will start ullage, and then, now that assumes we actually burn the whole way. I think we're going to come up 10 seconds short, so 1 minute 45 seconds is when we actually want to start. So at 2 minutes, I'll engage MechJib. So yes, I've dumped the excess propellants in this stage such that our ejection burn takes less time than it otherwise would. And I just did a quick ignition there just to try to remind MechJib of what's going on here. Hopefully it will now be more correct about burn times and things. What was I saying? 1 minute 50 seconds, I believe. Okay. We are aligned with that indicator. We're at 2 minutes and 10 seconds. We'll engage at 2 minutes. Okay, ullage and ignition. So that started a little early, but that's because MechJib was, I think, confused about how long the burn would actually take. but that's okay. We'll be like 2 or 3 seconds early. I don't think that will be fatal to us. Custom windows are the best things in MechChip. Custom window editor, because like we stuck land and relative inclination here, we stuck the biome there, we have this whole wonderful ascent stats window. You know, we've stuck some extra stuff on that window. It's great. Remove that now. Okay, I'll have to remember on the next launch to actually map out when our next Mars and Venus windows are. Although I guess if I'm using Flyby Finder, I don't have to. I can just use Flyby Finder to have it tell us when they are. Yes, so we're going to be done burning about five. So our actual ejection vector will be about 5 seconds before our desired ejection vector. Assuming it's even around the node, which is not actually true because, of course, the distribution of delta V is such that for any given burn time, more of the thrust occurs later in the burn. So the whole burn half ahead and half behind the node isn't quite right, because you probably actually want to burn half your delta V before the node and half your delta V after the node. That's a nice silhouetted picture. Now it's interesting when you watch SpaceX footage that even the second stage of the Falcon 9 with its Merlin 1D vacuum engine, that exhaust is not the yellow orange you expect from Kerolox. It's actually much closer to this in vacuum. I don't really know why that is. Yes, we're definitely finishing earlier than we should on this burn. Most definitely. That is going to mean that our ejection vector is going to be a little bit off. Okay. Alright, so for once we finished burning a little bit early, because I aborted a little bit early. Now let's go look at Mars. Focus view on Mars. Where is our current... Do we even have a... No, we haven't even intercepted yet. Did we burn too much or too little? Let's find out. We did actually burn a little too little. So we'll finish it on RCS. All right, now let's look at this. We're moving that inwards, and bam! Look at that. Absolutely sterling. We're actually getting as low a... Peri-Aries as one could hope. So we're going to have it just outside the atmosphere, but the issue, of course, is that we're actually going to need to correct our inclination the ascending slash descending node. I don't know which node it is for this. Because, of course, we're going to want to arrive, if not already in the plane of these moons, we're going to want to arrive such that at least our peri-Aries is right over the equator, such that we can perform a plane change at Apo-Aries. All right, let's go ahead and discard the Mariner transfer stage, slash upper stage, slash amazing piece of Hydrolox engineering. There we are. And I'm going to go ahead and extend panels. I'm not EJ, but I like me some panels, just different kind of panels. All right, now let's warp until we're out in the sunlight. We've picked up a little bit of a tumble, but I don't care. All right, now we should just about be in sunlight, I think. Or not. Where is the Earth? Now we're in sunlight. All right. There's the Earth, there's the Sun. Man, that's a pretty picture. All right, so okay, we have stabilized at this orientation. We're going to add an SOI exit alarm. And now, finally, we're going to go ahead and launch the last of our Mars probes for this window. And yeah, so okay. We'll head on back to the Space Center. We'll go ahead and go to Sparrow 6. Dawn is breaking. It's dawn at the Cape. What time is it right now? 11:36. That means it's October, so 11 minus 5. So it is 6:38 a.m. local time. Nice dawn. We'll get Sparrow 6. Now, Sparrow 6 is that little probe we designed at the end of yesterday's episode, basically just to score a whole lot of cash. it's sending a one-way trip for a camera to orbit of Phobos, of all places. But, you know, if they want to pay us $1 billion to do it, go us. We'll do it. Now, this launch looks broadly equivalent to the last launch. We didn't end up quite high enough last time, so we're going to pitch a little bit higher this time. Target the moon again. We'll warp yet another day. Set as target. Now our Mercury window's in 25 days. We're going to go ahead and roll out Labrador 10, and we'll perform the Labrador 10 mission while we're waiting for our Mercury window. All right, so targeted the moon. It's at 10 degrees and rising, so we'll warp a day. We don't need that up anymore. Already dealt with that. Oh, except to look at the science. All right, our R&D center is coming up in half a year. High power electrics in 82 days. Only space stations in another 142 days. So, very well. Very well. And off we go. Clamps away. As usual, head a little south. Why the docking port? And where? I must have misclicked somewhere. Maybe during the warp. Max Q. I'm going to have a lower max Q than last time. And 29.05 kilopascals of dynamic pressure is our max Q on this launch. Great ball of fire behind us. All right, we're going to continue down south a little bit more than last time, out to maybe 1300 meters per second. See how that works. Oh yes, all the RCS on this is quite sane, so we already fixed the staging and all these things. Don't worry about that. 15 seconds to first stage burnout. burnout. And second stage ignition. Pitch up. Fairing separation. Fairing sides. Let's just look at it in GUI-less splendor for a minute. Have we seen the... No, the sun is not yet up. Okay, I'm gonna pitch up a little bit more. This time we're gonna... there's a little bit of sunlight. This time we're gonna go up a little bit higher than last time. Now our apogee is getting quite high. I guess we can pitch down a little bit. Before I forget, let's go ahead and activate. Put this to Earth. We'll activate this and put it to active vessel. Kind of like ears. That's as close as we're getting to the plane of the moon. I guess we didn't quite go south enough. We're going quite high this time before we start falling back down. Now we've started falling back down. And we'll let the vertical speed build up for a minute and then pitch back up. I'm not actually sure what's an optimal approach for all this. Still got almost a minute 30 seconds burn time remaining on the stage. You can see how badly it cuts us that we have only 8 knights to thrust on that engine that we used to before the real overhaul upgrade that made those stats more accurate. Alright, let's pitch back up again. Still to orbit, 2 kilometers per second until we get to orbit. Alright. 15 seconds to stage 2 burnout. Getting ready for stage 3. Performed the ullage and then throttled up again. That was pretty cool. That was really legit pretty cool. How's our pitch looking? That's okay. We've still got a ways to go. 1300 meters per second. Second until orbit, so we need to start killing off that vertical speed pretty soon. Refining final inclination. Okay, we're just coming up on target. This is great. This is just great. And insertion. That's pretty good. That's really quite nice. Our land is exactly correct. Our relative inclination is quite low. Our orbit is quite close to circular. It's only 1 kilometer off circular. Our vertical velocity is minus 0.6 meters per second. That's pretty nice. Now let's go ahead and set up our Mars transfer. Set as target. Pork chops, tasty. Any time now. Create node is again going to be in about 50 minutes. That's sensible. Okay, and it looks like we used somewhat less delta V getting to orbit than the last time. Steering losses were lower, 93.44 meters per second to get to orbit. Now, if you remember those times when we did like 8,800 meters per second to orbit, that is the difference higher gravity losses make and higher steering losses. Because effectively, steering losses, unless we're talking about the steering losses but when we're going to the left and to the right for aligning our plane, all those steering losses are effectively just gravity losses, really. You can just combine those two numbers as basically the total for the gravity losses. Because they're delta V we have burned that is not contributing to orbital velocity because we had to fight the force of gravity. So let's do our usual trick of deactivate this. Now we want to align with the sun. So we want to come up and to the right. That's just about correct, I believe. So now we're going to go ahead and warp until a bit before the node. Whoa, that's closer to the node than I would have liked. And let's go ahead and dump some excess locks. We have way too much locks. All right, so we're talking about a minute and 30 seconds. Whoops, we went past our dagnabbit. Got to reline up and get rid of a whole bunch of LH2. Okay, and ullage and fire it up. Alright, so we're actually gonna burn MechJeb, shuts off the engines before throttling them up again. Great. Well, whatever. It's all fine. This is gonna work out just fine. Seconds to the node. Probably have about 2 minutes and 10 seconds of burn remaining. Maybe 2 minutes and 5, something like that. Once again, it's a burn on the night side of the Earth. Just now passing the node, and we have not burned quite half of our delta V. Close to half of our delta V. Far so good. 1.3 kilometers per second remaining. Second remaining. We're gonna end right about correct. Let's get ready to abort a little bit early. That's a little bit more early than I would have liked, but at least we didn't overburn. Let's go out and focus on target. Whoa, what the heck? What just happened? Somehow I managed to hit time warp? That's really pretty screwy. That was not cool. That was very much the wrong key to have hit. Given that is the case, I'm just going to go ahead and give myself back some electric charge, because that was just a... That was literally just hitting the wrong key. I didn't even think I'd hit the key. I don't even know what happened. Now we're like two-thirds of the way to the... No, one-third of the way to the moon. It's crazy. Let's create a fine-tune. Is that not even our target anymore? What the heck is going on here? Where's Mars? There's Mars. Set as target. Whoops, we burned through it. Great. You know what? At this point, I'm just annoyed. So, we will do that. And... Whoops. Gradually get back in range. focus in on Mars. Where is our... There we are. Gradually bring that in. Okay. And fix this one more time. All right, so we're definitely going to have to fine-tune this because that got all kinds of screwed up. And mark this as debris. And so that's some solar panels. More solar panels and the last solar panel. All right, and that's falling free. Now we'll go ahead and enable all the things. Fine-tune closest approach is also a ways out. So now we are going to add an alarm for you. So we have Owl 4, Owl 5, and Sparrow 6. They all are coming up on their SOI exits. So, warp to SOI. Oh, that's what must have happened. I must have somehow hit that. And that's how it triggered that warp. Not really sure how I managed to do that. Well, whatever. Okay, so we're going to want to go to Owl 4. Let this tumble a little bit. And we'll correct our stop our tumble right there. And warp, and we'll go ahead and warp out through SOI transition. And then we'll create our fine tune for Mars. Okay. Now, let's focus on Mars. That's a ridiculous distance away. All right, now let's zoom in and look at what plane is that in. That is not how we would like things to be. We want to be at least we want to have our periapsis at the AN or DN compared to the orbits of Phobos and Deimos. So let's go ahead and do a little bit of tweaking. Just a little bit. All right, that's acceptable. That's rather high as approach periapses go. That's made it worse. That's made it better. All right, and that's fairly close. I am okay with that. We will have to perform a plane change on arrival, but the plane change is quite slight when you think about it. See, we come in like this, so it's just like 5 to 10 degrees of plane change, and then we can aerobrake on down. So that's fine. So we'll add this as a fine-tune maneuver. L4 Mars FT. Great. Now we'll go ahead to L5. Jump to ship. Delete that. Also, how are things going? Okay, Labrador is ready to launch. So we're just going to have to ride this out for another day and a half before we go ahead and can launch Labrador 10. How is our solar? It's decent. We're getting a decent amount of solar power. We don't need much. Right, so we need to ride this one out. All right. Now let's go ahead and focus on Mars. And that is not an actually useful orbit. That is much more useful. So we rotate until that's centered over the planet. Let's raise it up a little bit. Down a little bit. What is it? It's a little high. That's looking much better. And once again, it's a fairly small plane change required. Right, let's add this alarm. Mars FT. Okay, so so far our 3, 5, 4, and Sparrow 6 will also have a fine tune of about the same time. Let's activate the other antenna as well. And active vessel. All right. Now. Jump to Sparrow 5, Sparrow 6, excuse me, and we'll ride Sparrow 6 out. Okay, its antennas are already all set. And it's got a ways to go. Oh, right, I have to remove this maneuver, the alarm first. Now we can warp out through it. Okay, we are now out in interplanetary space. Let's go ahead and look at Mars. And we will add a fine tune, which are we even coming in on the correct side of Mars? Yes, I think so. Yes, we are. All right, well, at least there's that. But this is not the inclination I would like. So let's fix things a little bit. All right, so that is a more expensive plane change than I would like, but it's how life has to be, I guess. The inner one is Phobos, so let's align Phobos correctly. And that's not that bad, really. inside the atmosphere. That at least is outside the atmosphere. Alright, so that is going to be our fine-tune maneuver. 10 meters per second, we'll accept it. Mars FT. Alright. So, those are our Mars probes on their way. Three probes, two of which are in fact probe triplets. Let's see if I forgot to garbage collect any stages. I did. What is this thing? That's just gonna be garbage. Debris. Alright. The rest of these things are sane. We almost have enough money to start upgrading the astronaut complex. What other things could we accept? Too late for that. Crewed lunar landing. By October 11th, 1964. It is October 12th, 1962. That gives us only 2 years. That is not really something I want to take on quite yet. We're almost ready. But we're not quite there yet, because we have to research the lander can, we have to, you know, research our engine and then test it in orbit. We need to have enough time to run a few test missions. So I don't think I want to take that contract on quite yet. Next, I want to look at what the deadline, because I'm always worried that we're going to... February 13th, 1964. Alright, so we still have a year and a half. That's acceptable. I think we'll be able to do that. Okay, we won't hit the crew duration record of 30 days until we accept that station contract. Until we complete it. I mean, we've already accepted it, of course. This does cost $1 million. $1 billion, I mean. $1 million funds. This also costs $1 million funds. It will at least give us a third build level in the VAB, and it will also increase our build rate some, just for free. We don't really need another level in the tracking station yet, because we're not planning to get an asteroid anytime soon. We don't care about the runway or the hangar. And we could upgrade a pad, but it's just... I don't know. It's just I feel like we're doing pretty well staying under the 800 ton limit. Although I am somewhat actually tempted to go build a third pad. We could build a third pad and upgrade one of our existing pads to tier 3 and have unlimited pad mass. Problem is just that $1 billion price tag is so high, and we know we need the astronaut complex so that we can properly train our astronauts for lunar missions, for landing on the moon. And then the second priority is probably the pad, and the third priority is the vehicle assembly building. This will be done in still half a year. Yeah, it's just everything takes forever. I'm tempted to. How much does that Jupiter contract give us? We're about to complete this. It gives us 191,000 funds. We're about to complete this, which also gives us a bunch of monies. So we'll net 400,000 funds in the next 40 days or so, which means that I can spend a fair amount buying, I think, some more tech, because once we get the 200,000 funds, so I want to be at about 850. Well, we'll do 845. Increase that a little bit. Getting close to two science a day. Yeah, so it's October 12th, 1962. We are at how many upgrades was that? 380 something? No, just shy of 400 upgrades. 1.86 science a day. That did not decrease it all that much. Took maybe shaved 10 days off early space stations. But 10 days is fine. Okay, so I think at this point I probably should call it quits for the night. Again, I apologize for the early interruption. So thank you everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I hope that it was helpful. You learned something from it. And I hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.